Abdominal injuries occur commonly in both blunt and penetrating trauma and can be life-threatening. The mechanism can give you a hint as to what injuries you might find. For example, the liver and spleen are commonly injured in blunt trauma, while penetrating injuries often involve the small bowel. In the trauma bay, I always follow ATLS protocol. The abdomen is one of the main sources of bleeding, so we begin with the primary survey. Look at the patient. Are they awake, comfortable, and talking, or do they look sick? What are their vital signs? Are they in shock? Most patients should receive 1 liter of warmed fluid. Their response to this can be an extra clue to determine if and how much they are bleeding. Perform a FAST, a rapid bedside ultrasound, looking for free fluid in the abdomen. If there's fluid, it's a positive FAST, and this fluid is usually blood. Then, as part of the secondary survey, do a full abdominal exam. Start with inspection. Is there bleeding? Are there gunshot or stab wounds? Is there a seatbelt sign that should make you very suspicious of underlying organ injury? Then palpation. Is there any tenderness or signs of peritonitis? This could suggest perforation of the gastrointestinal tract. Then a digital rectal examination. Is the prostate normal? Is there any rectal blood? A high riding prostate suggests urethral injury, as does blood at the meatus. If you see these, don't put in a catheter. Now we have to decide if this patient requires an emergency laparotomy. If the patient has a positive FAST with hypotension and tachycardia, peritonitis, or stab wounds that penetrate the abdominal fascia, then they need an operation now. Otherwise, we have time to do a CT scan to visualize and characterize any intra-abdominal injuries or active bleeding. The CT scan, combined with our findings from the physical exam and FAST, help us to decide the next steps. This might be an operation, angiography, or observation.